Obesity. Obesity is the excess of adipose tissue in the body. It is measured by, the first one is body mass index or BMI. According to WHO, BMI for Asian population is taken as less than 18.5 kg per meter square is underweight. 18.5 to 22.9 kg per meter square is normal weight. 23 to 24.9 kg per meter square is overweight. 25 to 29.9 kg per meter square is obese one. Greater than 30 kg per meter square is considered as obese two. BMI is calculated by weight in kgs upon height square in meters. Height. Thirdly, by the skin fold thickness method, it is determined by using special calipers over the biceps and the triceps muscles. Waist circumference and the waist to hip ratio. Waist circumference is done between the rib cage and the iliac crest. Greater than 80 cm in females and greater than 90 cm in males is considered to be abdominal obesity. Causes of obesity include physical inactivity, eating habits, psychological factors like anxiety, depression, genetic factors. Other causes include hypothyroidism, Cushing syndrome, diabetes mellitus. Genetic factors include leptin. Leptin is a hormone produced by the adipose tissue. It controls the food intake and the energy expenditure. Defect in leptin can result in obesity. Obese people have low levels of leptin in the blood, while high-level leptin indicates resistance. The second factor is lipoprotein lipase. This is synthesized by adipocytes, which helps in the breakdown of fats. Risk factors or complications of obesity include coronary artery disease, type 2 diabetes mellitus and insulin resistance, varicose veins, depression, dyslipidemia, which means imbalance of lipids in the blood, cholelithiasis, sleep apnea syndrome, osteoarthritis, that is degeneration of joints, and deep vein thrombosis. Treatment or management of obesity. The goals include reducing weight by 10% from the baseline weight, reducing the weight at a rate of 1 kg per week for 6 months. Firstly, we have diet. Low-fat diet. Include 500 calories per day. Reducing fat alone without reducing calories is not sufficient. Low-fat diet has low energy density than high-fat diet. Low-fat diet also has high fiber content. Therefore, it enhances satiety. The second one is low-carbohydrate diet. This diet works with high saturated fats, but the disadvantage includes constipation. The third one is high-protein diet. This type of diet increases satiety. Fat percentage is kept low. Disadvantage: patients with impaired renal function with greater protein intake face difficulties. Increased consumption of red meat also increases the risk of colon cancer. So these are the disadvantages. Then we have physical exercise. Moderate exercises should be done for at least 30 to 45 minutes, 3 to 5 days per week. Benefits of physical exercise: decreases abdominal fat, increases cardiorespiratory fitness. Then we have behavior modification. Patient requires motivation to lose weight. Then we have surgical management. That includes bariatric surgery. It is useful when patients have medical, physical, and psychological problems associated with obesity. This includes jaw wiring, gastroplasty, gastrojejunostomy, liposuction, laparoscopic adjustable gastric bending. Drugs include sibutramine, orlistat, rimonabant. The first one is sibutramine. It suppresses appetite. Adverse effect includes dry mouth, constipation, headache, insomnia. Orlistat. Orlistat binds to the intestinal lipase in the gut. It decreases the absorption of triglycerides and cholesterol. Adverse effects: oily stools, fecal urgency, diarrhea, flatulence.